next property. Now this is a also called triangle inequality. This sum of the two complex numbers and its modulus is equal to individually finding the modulus and then adding it. Okay, so let's prove it. Proof. Now z1 plus z2 square, this is equal to z1 plus z2 and z1 plus z2 conjugate. This we have used from property 2. Now this further we can write it z1 plus z2 with z1 conjugate of z1 plus conjugate of z2. Now multiplying these two, what we are getting? Z1 conjugate of z1 plus z1 z2 conjugate plus z2 z1 conjugate plus z2 and z2's conjugate. Now further we can write it this one, z1's conjugate plus z2's conjugate. I have written first and the fourth term first, plus z2's conjugate plus this term plus z2 and z1 conjugate. Is it clear? This term first of all I have written, then I have written this, then this one and then this one. Now what further we can write to this one? Now this becomes what? Z1 square plus square of z2 plus, now to this term what I can write it? Can I write it z1 z2's conjugate plus z1 z2's conjugates and its conjugate? Just look once again. If we are having z2 z1 and its conjugate, what it will become now? This will become conjugate of z2 times conjugate and again conjugate of z1. So this becomes conjugate of z2 and z1. So that's what I have written, z1 z2's conjugate and bar on it, a conjugate on it. Now conjugate of z1 z2 is equal to conjugate of z1 times conjugate of z2 and conjugate is equal to z. This I have used just now, I explained you. Now this becomes square of the modulus of complex number first and square of the modulus of complex number 2 plus twice of real part for z1 and z2's conjugate. Now basically what this is? Basically this is, now if we are just adding a complex number and its conjugate, what the result is? Result is this one. How this is? Just let me tell you. We are having z is equal to 3 plus 4 iota. Conjugate of z will be 3 minus 4 iota. Now if we are adding this one, what we are getting? 3 plus 4 iota plus 3 minus 4 iota. This is twice of 3. 3 plus 3, twice of 3. Or to this we can write twice of the real part of a z. That's what we have done it. Is it clear? Now z1's modulus of first complex number square, modulus of second complex number square, plus when we are adding this one using this part, we are getting twice of real part of z1 and z2. Now we can write it z1 plus z2 square is less than is equal to z1 square plus modulus of z2 square plus twice of z1 z2 square. Now why I have written this part? Why I have used an inequality? Just now we have gone through property 6. Now let me write it here. We are having, since a is less than is equal to square root of a square plus b square, z is equal to a plus iota b. This is a complex number. Okay, we are knowing that real part, a is what? A is the real part. Real part will always be less than is equal to the square root for a square plus b square. That is the absolute value. Okay, or to this one, what we can write it? Real part of z is less than is equal to modulus of z, property 6. This was property 6, we have done it. Or what we can write it? Real part of a complex number can never exceeds its absolute value. So this is whole all the thing which is very important, why we have used an inequality here. Now plus z2 the square is less than is equal to z1 square modulus of z2 its square and 2 times z1 and conjugate of z2. Now to this what we can write it? Mod of z1 square plus modulus of z2 square plus 2z1 and z2. Now what we have doing here? Again we are having one of the property we have done it. That's why modulus of a mod of a z2 and its conjugate, that is equal to mod of a z2. Now z1 plus z2 square is less than is equal to z1 plus z2, sorry, z1 plus z2 whole square. This is the identity which we have using. Now taking positive square root, z1 plus z2 is less than is equal to z1 plus modulus of z2. Here it is in the combined form. Modulus of z1 plus z2, modulus of z1 plus z2 summation is always less than or equal to modulus of z1 plus modulus of z2. Proved.